Good morning. Welcome to Rio Rancho United Methodist Church on this beautiful Sunday morning. Please rise as you are able and join us in singing our opening hymn, number 383 in the United Methodist hymnal, This is a Day of New Beginnings. We'll be singing verses 1 through 4.
Good morning. How is everyone this morning? Good. Okay, I only wear aprons on special occasions. Today, the kids are in the kitchen making breakfast burritos for sale. So it kind of smells good in here. So hopefully they'll be yummy. If you haven't had the opportunity to order one, you can come in and order after worship. I usually buy enough supplies to make plenty, so we shouldn't run out. You should be good, even if you haven't gotten to order one yet. Paint night is this coming Friday night. We'll be painting, looks like a fence and a meadow. So if anybody is interested in coming to paint night, if you could just let me know, that way I know how much food to plan on. It's $10 per person. That includes the cost of all of the supplies plus a light supper. So. And you know, if you are not a painter, if maybe you've never painted a picture before, that's okay. I'll give you instructions on how to do it. So it's just a lot of, I find it relaxing. My daughter finds it tedious. So, you know, you just have to decide if it's something you might like to try. So we welcome everybody. And nobody's picture ever looks alike. I can paint three of them and they never look exactly the same. So it's okay if yours doesn't look exactly like the sample. So if you'd like to come, we would love to have you. And then on the 27th, which is a Saturday, we're having the community garage sale out in the parking lot. So if anybody would like a space for that, spaces are $10 and you bring your stuff and sell your own stuff. If you love shopping at garage sales, make sure you come shopping because we'll have lots of different people here from the community and from the church all selling stuff. So you never know what you might find. You know that old saying, one man's trash is another man's treasure? We'll have a lot of that. So you just never know what kind of treasures you might find. As always, there's a lot of information on the back of the bulletin, so you want to check that out. And you want to take this little flappy part and tear it off. And you fill out this inside here with your name. If we already have your address and everything, you don't have to fill everything out. Just put your name, where you're sitting, that kind of thing. And if you have any questions about the church, you know, maybe there's something you've been wanting to know and you haven't been able to find somebody to ask, write it down here. And then when you drop this in the offering plate along with your offering, then we take those, and if there's questions, we can call you and talk to you about whatever it is that you would like to know. So be sure and do that. And I believe that is all of the announcements for this morning. So if you would please join me in the call to worship. Therefore, as you received Christ Jesus as Lord, continue to live in him, rooted and built up in him, and strengthened in the faith, just as you were taught, overflowing with thankfulness. For in Christ, all the fullness of the deity lives in bodily form, and we have been given the fullness in Christ, who is the head over every power and authority. And you, who were dead in your trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made alive together with him, having forgiven all our trespasses by canceling the record of debt that stood against us with its legal demands. This he set aside, nailing it to the cross. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Our call to prayer this morning is number 395 in the United Methodist hymnal, Take Time to Be Holy. We'll be singing verse 2, and we invite you to join in singing with us.
Please join me in prayer. Good morning, Lord. Thank you for this beautiful sunny day with gorgeous blue skies and a few clouds now and then. Thank you, Lord, for this beautiful creation that you've given to us and for all of the blessings that you pour out on each and every one of us every single day. We thank you, Lord, for the biggest blessing of all, and that is your Son, Jesus Christ, who was willing to walk to that cross for us. Dear Lord, we pray that you can move in our hearts and in our minds, and you can help us to be the kind, thoughtful, caring, and giving children that you have always wanted us to be. And Lord, we know that, especially in our world today, there is such ugliness going on. There is such danger to others. There are people who are forgetting completely that you've given us the kindness and the generosity and the hope. Help us, Lord, to understand that no matter